What's the best thing about being famous?
Do crazy stuff, yeah. Being able to dress silly.
Welcome to The Stir, everybody. My name is Franco Mabanta. Belated Happy Victoria Court Day, AKA belated Happy Valentine.
Please, Valentine's Day was invented to make people feel like if they're not part of some perfect couple.
True. Anyway, here are the top five shows that will get your adrenaline pumping. At number five, we have I, Boy. This Netflix original film is about a 16-year-old boy who's attacked by a group of thugs, falls into a coma, and awakens to discover bits of his shattered smartphone bizarrely embedded into his brain, thus giving him superpowers. The only superpower I've ever gotten after waking up with a broken phone and a headache is the superpower of magically making an ex-girlfriend angry. At number four, we have Black Sails Season 3. Imagine what would happen if Captain Jack Sparrow and Spartacus made a baby. That's disgusting. There you have it. Long John Silver in the spine-tingling action-packed series, Black Sails. In this period piece that is the grimy, violent, thrilling world of pirates, Bay produces some of his best work. Black Sails is a win.
England takes whatever, whenever, however it wants.
At number three, we got Ultimate Beastmaster. Now, the last few years have seen Netflix elevate the reality content game with cooking shows, science documentaries, live concerts, crime investigations, and stand-up comedy specials that took risks, were incredibly well-produced, and became popular all over the world. In this format new to Netflix, the man with the most famous forearms in the history of humanity, the legendary Sylvester Stallone, is executive producer and host to an original show that unapologetically fuses American Ninja Warrior and Wipeout and Pacific Rim. It's the Godzilla of American Gladiators. If Godzilla was juicing on every ruthless, illegal steroid banned by the UFC. Take it away, Rambo.
This is Ultimate Beastmaster.
At number two this week, we got Santa Clarita Diet. Now this one's hella fun. The eternally adorable Drew Barrymore plays Sheila, who suddenly develops a desire to literally eat people. The results are amazing as her skin clears, her mind sharpens, her energy brightens, and her life instantly elevates. A weird and lighthearted cross between Dexter and The Walking Dead, Drew eventually goes full on zombie mode and starts eating men who probably deserve to be eaten, aligning her character along the likes of Dracula, Hannibal Lecter, and Sasha Gray.
At casual.
At number one, we have Iron Fist. Finally joining the ranks of Daredevil, Jessica Jones, and Luke Cage, we have Iron Fist. In this latest release from Marvel's TV division, we follow Danny Rand. With his martial arts prowess and supercharged chi, Marvel fans of the world rejoice. Just a few months before Thanos collects all the Infinity Stones in the cinematic universe, Netflix completes The Defenders. What a great time to be a fan. Gents, Iñigo Pascual is here. You know, you're going through this thing right now that very few people in history ever go through, which is you're extraordinarily famous at a very young age. How are you handling it?
To be honest, I don't think about it. I mean, like my dad, I'm glad that I have him by my side. I mean, somewhat sure. Training me for it. There's positive and negative things about it. I mean, the fact that he's such a big star makes me somewhat scared. I felt as if I had to be as good as him or as good looking as him.
It's funny you said that because it's like, oh, clearly you're a very good looking young man. But when I go on your Instagram account and you go in the comment section, everyone's like, your dad is so hot.
Exactly. Every time I have events, I'd have like moms literally coming up to me saying, I'm your mom. Yeah, because of my dad. But they're saying that they're married to my dad or
that's
something.
That's a great story.
Having him as a standard, you know what I mean? People would have that like idea that you, being the son of Piolo Pascual, you'd have to be this level already, like once you start. I did my first movie when I was 15. I was in 10th grade. Mm-hmm. After that, I joined a boy band in Tennessee. The contract was not, it was too one-sided, so I didn't continue with that. Okay. I came back here for the premiere night of my first movie. After that, I didn't even go to school anymore.
What's the best thing about being famous?
How do you give a good answer to this?
like, what are the perks that you enjoy? You're all sweaty. Yeah. Sorry. Don't worry. Don't let me pressure you. Like I'm dressed like Willy Wonka's boyfriend.
What do I enjoy? I guess just being able to do crazy stuff, yeah. Being able to dress silly. People will think it's weird, but you're able to just go out there and do your own thing. People will be like, oh, that's kind of cool. Let's do that as well.
Conversely, what's the worst thing about being famous?
You're giving your privacy away. That's for sure. There was this one time I was wearing a a mask to the mall. Parang, why are you hiding? Why are you doing this? Parang, I didn't want to be rude. I don't want to hide myself. I don't want to seem like a snob or anything.
Because it's a lose-lose. If you tell people, oh, I'm wearing a mask because I'm famous, you sound like a douche.
Yeah, exactly. But that's not the point at all.
What fame really is, it's just air. You elevate yourself only through two ways. One is if you really love what you do, and two is if you're kind to other people. Yeah. You know what I mean? Like fame, it's not really a real thing. If you get famous by doing one of those two things, then great. Otherwise, it's just whatever. Okay, Netflix fan.
Well,
let's get into it.
I've been watching The OA.
How do you find it so far?
It's crazy. I mean, I honestly don't get it, but that's the best thing about it. Like, it makes you want to keep watching it. It started with this girl, this blind girl named Prairie.
Right.
And basically, like, she had a near-death experience. And this one guy, he had this lab for people that had near-death experiences, and he wanted to experiment, like, how they felt during those times. Where did they go?
7 years ago, when she went missing, she was blind.
Mom?
Before I came to the Philippines, I was obsessed with Teen Wolf. I started to think that I was Scott McCall, but I was too obsessed with it.
I kissed her.
I saw.
She kissed me.
Saw that too.
Also, Stranger Things.
Yeah.
It's something parang interesting, but it makes you want to keep watching it because it's so mysterious. Parang you'd want to watch till the end to find out what it really is. I recently just started watching K-dramas. I enjoy Korean films. I enjoy Korean K-pop.
Korean girls?
Yeah.
실컷 봐. 돈 안 받을 테니까.
I'm excited to watch, which I found out Netflix has now, which I'm very excited
They've got
for.
Like this vault of special Japanese anime and then Korean films and stuff.
I find their productions interesting, like parang every time I watch it, I get motivated to perform and all that.
All right, I'm gonna end with this. I think that the knock on a lot of millennials is that a lot of millennials are entitled. I've hung out with you several hours before this and I've seen your interviews and all that stuff and in this interview, you're absolutely not. And it's really cool. And considering you're the son of the biggest movie star in the country, I think this is a really great spot to start your adulthood. So congratulations, man. Pleasure to meet
you.
Iñigo Pascual, everybody. Hey guys, thanks for watching. Click here to subscribe for more episodes of The Stir. Leave a comment in the comment section. The best comments get free Netflix.